So this is lecture number 13 today, and in the previous lecture we have discussed the basic operating principle of single phase auto transformer and the different volt ampere relations and the different types of power transferred from primary to secondary. So today in this lecture we will discuss some advantages of auto transformer and applications of auto transformer. So see here, the main advantage of auto transformer we have discussed in the previous lecture, that there is a large saving in the conducting material. Okay, वहां पर क्या हो रहा था कि टू वाइंडिंग ट्रांसफॉर्मर की कंपैरिजन में जो हमारा मटेरियल था, जो मटेरियल हम वाइंडिंग के लिए यूज कर रहे थे, काफी हद तक वो मटेरियल क्या हो रहा था, हमारा रिड्यूस हो रहा था बाय ए फैक्टर ऑफ 1/KE. वी हैव ड्राइव KE इज द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन रेशियो ऑफ ऑटो ट्रांसफॉर्मर. सो इस रेशियो से क्या हो रहा था, इस फैक्टर से क्या हो रहा था, हमारे कॉपर मटेरियल जो यूज कर रहे थे वाइंडिंग में उसमें सेविंग हो रही थी. सो बेस्ड ऑन दैट यू कैन सी हियर, इफ देयर इज ए रिडक्शन इन द कॉपर मटेरियल रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द वाइंडिंग, अगर आपका मटेरियल कम होगा तो मटेरियल कम होने के साथ कौन कौन से आपके एडवांटेजेस होंगे. देखिएगा, अगर आपका मटेरियल रिड्यूस होता है, इट मींस द कॉस्ट ऑफ द ट्रांसफॉर्मर विल रिड्यूस. देयरफॉर दिस इज द फर्स्ट एडवांटेज, दैट द मटेरियल कॉस्ट इज रिड्यूस्ड. एंड सेकेंड एडवांटेज इज दैट द लॉसेज रिड्यूस्ड. इट मीन्स जब आप कम मटेरियल यूज करोगे तो बाइंडिंग का रेजिस्टेंस क्या होगा, आपका कम होगा, और जब बाइंडिंग का रेजिस्टेंस कम होगा तो कॉपर लॉस क्या होंगे, आपकी कम हो जाएंगी, जिसकी वजह से लॉसेस क्या होंगे, आपकी रिड्यूस हो जाएंगी. और आपको पता है कि अगर आपकी लॉसेस रिड्यूस होंगी तो एफिशिएंसी इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू लॉसेस. अगर लॉसेस कम होंगी तो आपके ट्रांसफॉर्मर की एफिशिएंसी क्या होगी, इंक्रीज हो जाएगी. तो दिस इज द थर्ड एडवांटेज, दैट एफिशिएंसी इंक्रीजेज और इंप्रूव्ड. एंड फोर्थ एंड लास्ट इज, क्योंकि कम मटेरियल आप यूज कर रहे हो तो इसका मतलब क्या होगा, वाइंडिंग का आपका रेजिस्टेंस कम होगा, वाइंडिंग का आपका लीकेज रिएक्टेंस कम होगा, जिसकी वजह से ट्रांसफॉर्मर के अंदर जो वोल्टेज ड्रॉप होगा दैट विल रिड्यूस. और अगर आपका वोल्टेज ड्रॉप रिड्यूस होता है तो आपको पता है वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन आपका क्या हो जाएगा, इंप्रूव हो जाएगा. मींस इन द टॉपिक ऑफ वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन आई हैव डिस्कस दैट वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन इज नथिंग बट इट इज द टोटल परसेंटेज ड्रॉप इन द ट्रांसफॉर्मर, दैट इज वोल्टेज ड्रॉप. सो ड्यू टू लो वोल्टेज ड्रॉप इन द रेजिस्टेंस एंड रिएक्टेंस द वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन विल इम्प्रूव. सो देयर आर दीज फोर मेन एडवांटेज ऑफ द ऑटो ट्रांसफॉर्मर. फर्स्ट ऑफ वन इज द मटेरियल कॉस्ट इज रिड्यूस, सेकेंड इज द लॉस इज रिड्यूस, थर्ड इज द एफिशियंसी इंक्रीजेस, एंड फोर्थ इज ड्यू टू लो वोल्टेज ड्रॉप in resistance and reactance the voltage regulation improves. And these four conditions are very desirable. Okay, now next is application of auto transformer. Means auto transformer ko hum use kahan karte hain, iska kya use hai. To dekhiyega, sabse pehle kya hota hai ki agar kisi power system mein, suppose hamare paas do substation hai, ek substation aapka suppose 33,000 volt ka hai या 33 केवी का है, और एक आपका सपोज 132 केवी का है. अगर दो सबस्टेशन को हमें इंटरकनेक्ट करना है तो फॉर द इंटरकनेक्शन ऑफ टू सबस्टेशन और टू पावर सिस्टम दैट आर ऑपरेटिंग एट डिफरेंट वोल्टेज लेवल, देन वी विल यूज द ऑटो ट्रांसफॉर्मर. सो फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज इंटरकनेक्शन ऑफ पावर सिस्टम ऑफ डिफरेंट वोल्टेज लेवल्स. Second advantage is that you know that in case of distribution system there is a large drop, voltage drop in the line. So to boost up the voltage, to increase the voltage, we use the auto transformer. So it works as a voltage booster in distribution system to compensate the voltage drop. Voltage drop को compensate करने के लिए हम किसका use करते हैं, auto transformer का use करते हैं, जो किस तरह से use होता है, as a voltage booster. And third is that you know that in case of auto transformer we make different tapings at the secondary and we can obtain the desirable voltage that we require. Okay, so by using the tapings in the secondary winding of auto transformer we can obtain the desirable voltage whatever we require. So you know that in case of induction motor, when we start the induction motor, we start the induction motor at low voltage. So this tapings can be used, these tapings can be used to obtain the low voltage, and therefore it is used to start the induction motor. So dear student, these are some advantages of auto transformer and these are applications. After that, we will discuss how a two winding transformer can be converted into a auto transformer. That is very very important problem, because mostly numerical problem is asked based on this topic, that you have to given a two winding transformer and you have to convert this two winding transformer into an auto transformer. So let's discuss the next topic. So this is the conversion of, this is conversion of two winding transformer into auto transformer. That is very very important, because problem is asked based on this conversion. So this is very important topic, keep in mind. Okay, so here we will have a two winding transformer. Suppose we have two winding transformer like that. This is two winding transformer, this is the core, this is two winding transformer like that. Suppose here the voltage, primary voltage is V1 and secondary voltage we are getting, that is V2, and secondary current suppose this is I2 and primary current this is suppose I. Okay, suppose this is the dot here, this is the dot. So first point to be keep in mind, that you can see here that always a transformer is negatively coupled. Always a transformer is negatively coupled. You can see here at the dot the primary current is entering, but at the dot the secondary current is leaving. So always the transformer operates on the principle of negatively coupled circuit. So keep in mind, when we will convert this two winding transformer into auto transformer, always you have to follow the law. If one of the primary or secondary current is entering at the dot, then the next or secondary current should leave the dot. Okay, so here you can see that dot is always considered as positive. So here the voltage is V1, this is plus, this is minus, and also this is plus, this is minus, this is V2. Now we have to convert this two winding transformer into auto transformer. So let KVA of two winding transformer is equal to, that is KVA 2 winding. The KVA rating of two winding transformer will be given. So we can calculate the rated primary and secondary current, that is I1 is equal to KVA of two winding multiplied by 1000 divided by V1. V1 will be given. Similarly, we can calculate the secondary current, rated secondary current, that is KVA of two winding into 1000 divided by V2. So in this way, the data of the two winding transformer given, what is the KVA rating of two winding transformer, the rated primary and secondary voltages. So you can calculate with the help of this data the primary and secondary rated current. Now we have to convert this two winding transformer into auto transformer. So there are two methods to convert the two winding transformer into auto transformer. The first method is by using additive polarity means the voltage V1 and V2 should be add. When the V1 or V2 will add, then this type of polarity will called as the additive polarity. When V1 and V2 are subtracted, means V1 minus V2, if the result is V1 minus V2, then it is called as the subtractive polarity. So first we will discuss the additive polarity. So see here, In case of additive polarity, we should get the total voltage V1 plus V2. So we have to add the voltage V1 and V2. Suppose this point is A, this is B, this point is C, and this is D. So let's draw first the winding AB. Suppose this is A and this point is B. and this winding is CD. You know both the winding are connected in series. So this winding is CD. Now see here, the dot is here at A. Okay, so we will get this is plus, A point will be plus, B point will be minus, and the voltage across AB is equal to how much? This is equal to V1. Now we have to add the voltage of CD. The voltage of CD is equal to V2. So we have to add V1 plus V2. So plus sign should be here and minus sign should be here. Then V1 plus V2 will be the result. So dot should be at C. I already said that it is considered that the dot is positive and undot end is negative. So in this way we will get the total input voltage to auto transformer that is equal to how much? That is V1 plus V2. Okay. So if we are getting V1 plus V2, then it is called as the additive polarity. Now we have to obtain the secondary side, means we have to connect the load. So there are two terminals. Either we can connect the load across CD or we can connect the load AB. So we will see one by one. First, we will taking the connection of this type that we are connecting the load across CD. So we are connecting the load here like that. This is load. Okay. Now the voltage across this load is how much? It is equal to V2. Okay, now we have to, the main function is that we have to distribute the appropriate distribution of, we have to make the appropriate distribution of current. Main kaam hota hai ki current ko distribute karna. Okay, now see here, the current in primary winding, that is AB, the current is how much? It is rated current is I1, means the winding AB can carry the maximum current of I1, and the current is entering at the dot, means here the current will be I1. Okay, because AB winding can carry the maximum current of I1, it means the direction of current I1 is that this is I1. Okay, now we have to see the direction of current in CD winding. In CD, the CD winding can carry the current I2. Okay, so the current in CD should be equal to I2, but keep in mind that the connection should be negatively coupled. Means if the current is entering at A, then the current should leave at point C. Clear? So you can see here the current should leave. So the current is entering at point A. So the current should leave at point C. So this is I2. So apply KCL here. You can, this current will be how much? I1, because the total entering current is I1. So total leaving current should be I1. So apply KCL here. I1 is incoming, I2 is incoming. So the direction of load current will be like that. This will be equal to I1 plus I2. Okay. So in this way, you can obtain the connection of auto transformer. Keep in mind always, we have to cover the auto transformer or the two winding transformer as negatively coupled. So again, I am repeating, because in AB winding, the current is entering at the dot A. So in CD winding, the current should leave the dot, means the current should be leave the dot, means current should be passed like that. So direction of current will be from D to C. You can see here also, the current is from D to C, because the current is leaving this dot. Okay. So now we can obtain the KVA rating. KVA of auto transformer will be equal to how much? That is the rated apparent power output. So output power will be equal to how much? Output voltage is V2 and the current through the load is equal to I1 plus I2. In this way, we can obtain the rating of auto transformer. Similarly, we can obtain the transformation ratio of auto. That will be how much? That is primary voltage to secondary voltage, because turn ratio depends upon the voltage. Voltage is directly proportional to turn ratio. So it will be equal to V1 plus V2 divided by V2. So in this way, we can obtain the KVA rating of auto transformer and transformer, turn ratio of auto transformer. So this is the first type of connection that we can obtain with the help of two winding transformer, or it is called as additive polarity. Okay. Now we will draw the second type of connection. So in second type of connection, you can see here because we are using the same polarity. So you can see here like that, these are not the currents. Okay, see, this is because we have to obtain the additive polarity, so this connection will remain same, that is V1, that is V2. So the total voltage across terminal A and D will be equal to V1 plus V2. So it is additive polarity. But we can now connect the load across terminal AB like that. This is the load. This is load. See here, that is important. Keep in mind. Now we have to connect the load across terminal AB. Now the voltage across this load will be equal to how much? This will be equal to V1, not V2. In that case, the output voltage was V2, but in this case, the output voltage will be V1. Now, you can see here that we don't know the what is the value of current through AB. So, through AB, the current is equal to I1, but we don't know the direction of current, whether the current is entering at the node or leaving the node. So, in that type of connection, we will consider that this current is suppose I3. Always keep in mind, there was in the previous case, there was no this type of connection. So current was not distributing because this load was not connected across AB. So current was not distributing. Therefore, we considered that is the current I1 that is flowing through AB. But here, the connection is different. Some amount of current will pass through load. So we don't know the direction of current AB. So in that case, first we will consider the total current, suppose this is equal to I3. Now if this total current entering is I3, then this total current leaving should be I3. Okay. Now if this current is I3, then the current through this winding CD will be I3, because jo current CD mein hogi wahi aayegi. Aur direction kya hogi aapki? This will be the direction, this is I3. Okay. But you can see the current in CD should be equal to I2, because the maximum current that the winding CD can carry, that is equal to I2. So I3 is nothing but it is equal to I2. Okay. Now you can see here the I3 or I2 current is entering. Okay. The I3 or I2 current क्या कर रही है आपकी? Enter कर रही है. इसका मतलब क्या होना चाहिए? अगर ये enter कर रही है आपकी, तो AB वाइंडिंग में करंट क्या करनी चाहिए? लीव करनी चाहिए. AB वाइंडिंग में क्या करनी चाहिए? करंट आपकी लीव करनी चाहिए. मींस दिस विल बी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट. और AB कितनी करंट कैरी कर सकती है? I1. सो दिस इज करंट I1. यहां से देखिए, I3 क्या कर रही है? लीव कर रही है, सॉरी एंटर कर रही है. I3 C पर क्या कर रही है? एंटर कर रही है. तो I1 A पर क्या करनी चाहिए? लीव करनी चाहिए, बिकॉज वी हैव टू फॉलो द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नेगेटिवली कपल्ड सर्किट. सो यू कैन अप्लाई, दिस इज I3, सो I3 विल बी इक्वल टू I2, बिकॉज I3 इज इक्वल टू I2. सो वी कैन अप्लाई द KCL हेयर. सो द डायरेक्शन ऑफ लोड करंट विल बी दिस, सो इट विल बी इक्वल टू I1 प्लस I2. यू कैन सी हेयर द I1 इज कमिंग फ्रॉम हेयर, I2 इज कमिंग फ्रॉम हेयर. सो बोथ द करंट आर इनकमिंग करंट, सो आउटगोइंग करंट विल बी इक्वल टू I1 प्लस I2. Okay, so in that way we can obtain the KVA rating of auto transformer. That will be equal to output voltage is how much? V1 into output current is equal to I1 plus I2. In that case, transformation ratio of auto transformer will be equal to input voltage, that is V1 plus V2 upon output voltage, that is V1. So in that way we can got the connection. There are two types of connection in additive polarity. Okay. Now, okay. So these are the two types of connection that we have discussed in additive polarity. So you can use either of connection depending upon the requirement. We will discuss two numerical problem, then you will clearly understood that which type of connection we have to use. Now the second connection will be obtained through subtractive polarity. So next is number two is subtractive polarity. So in this connection we will use the subtractive polarity of voltage V1 and V2. So see here, now we have, this is AB, this is terminal A and this terminal is B and this terminal C and this terminal is D. Now we have to obtain the voltage here, that is V1 minus V2. Okay, because we have to use the subtractive polarity. So here the voltage is plus minus V1, because at dot it is considered that positive and at undot it is considered as negative. Now this sign should be negative and this sign should be positive. It means the dot should be here. Okay, and dot terminal is what? This is C. So this will be C terminal and this terminal should be B terminal. So if we will connect the winding A, B and DC in this manner, then we will get the output the voltage V1 minus V2, and this is called as subtractive polarity. Now to obtain the output we have to connect a load. So there are same two cases, either we can connect the load across CD and or we can connect the load across AB. So first we will connect the load across CD like that. This is point C and this is load. Okay, now you will get the output voltage like that. This is plus, this is minus, this is V. Okay, so the load current now flow in counterclockwise direction, because this is plus sign, this is minus sign, so this will be the direction of load current. Now similarly we can see here, in two winding transformer the winding AB can carry the maximum current of I1. So the current in AB is I1, means this is I1. I1 is entering at dot point A. So in winding CD the current should leave. So the direction of current in winding CD should be like that. Here this current is entering at point A, so at point C the current should leave. So this will be the direction of I2, like that. And now apply KCL here, you will get the current that is equal to I2 minus I1. Simple, you can apply the KCL. This is incoming current, this is outgoing current. So if you add these two current, that is I1 plus I2 minus I1, then you could get the value of current I2, and this current is equal to I1. Okay, so in this way you can connect the auto transformer. So in that case KVA rating, K, how much output voltage is V2 into output current is I2 minus I1, and transformation ratio K auto will be equal to the input voltage is now what, that is V1 minus V2 upon output voltage is V2. Okay, so this is one of the connection that will be used in auto transformer. Now in the second type of connection, we will connect the load across terminal A. See here, we don't have any type of current like that. So in that case we will connect the load across, this point is A, across terminal AB, this is B. So we will connect the load here like that. You can see this is load. So in that case the output voltage we are getting the output voltage, that is plus minus V1. So the direction of load current will be like that. The load current will enter at plus and will leave at minus. So now the winding AB can carry a total current of I1, but in that case we don't know what is the direction of AB. Either the AB is flowing from A to B or B to A, because at point A now a junction is created. In the previous case you have seen that at point A there was no junction, so the total current was entering at point A, that is at dot A. But here we don't know the direction of current in winding AB. So we will consider here that total current is suppose I3. So if the total current entering into the transformer is I3, then the total current leaving should be equal to I3. Okay. Now this current is I3, this current should pass through this winding CD, and the direction of I3 should be like that. This is I3. Now the maximum current that CD can carry, that is equal to I2. So I3 will be equal to how much? It will be equal to I2. So I3 is equal to I2. Okay. Now you can see here that at point C, the current I2 leaves the dot. It is leaving the dot. So at point A, the current should enter the dot. That is I1, because we have to follow the principle of negatively coupled. So at C, the current I2, you can see that it is leaving the dot. So at point A, the current should enter the dot. You can apply the KCL here. You can apply the KCL here. So you will get, this is I2 minus I1. So I1 is coming from here, I2 minus I1 is coming from here. So the current will remain I2. So output KVA rating will be equal to how much? Output voltage is V1 into current is I2 minus I1. And transformation ratio, that is K auto, is equal to, this is input voltage is V1 minus V2 upon output voltage is V1. So in this manner, we have graphed four type of connection, two with additive polarity and two with negative polarity. So now we will discuss the numerical problem based on these connections. So this is a numerical problem based on auto transformer. You can see here, a 400 by 100 volt 5 kVA two winding transformer is to be used as an auto transformer to supply power at 400 volt from 500 volt. Means the input voltage to the auto transformer should be 500 volt and output voltage should be 400 volt. Determine the KVA rating, transformation ratio and power transfer inductively as well as conductively. Also calculate the percentage saving in material. Okay. So you can see here, we have a two winding transformer like that. Okay. This point is A. This is V1. V1 is equal to how much? It is 400 volt. And this point is A. This point is B. This winding is suppose CD winding. This is C. And this is current I2. And this is terminal voltage V2 with polarity. This is plus, this is minus, this is plus, this is minus. V2 is equal to how much? It is 100 volt. Okay. So we can calculate first the rated current, that is I1 and I2. So I1 is equal to how much? The rating of this two winding transformer, that is KVA of two winding, is equal to 5 KVA. So we can calculate I1 is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 400. So you will get, this will be 6 point, this will be 400, it will be 12.5, it will be 12.5 ampere. Similarly, we can calculate I2. I2 is equal to 5 into 10 to the power 3 upon, it is 100, so it will be equal to 50 ampere. So with the help of KVA rating given of two winding transformer, we have determined the rated primary and secondary current. Okay. Now we have to obtain a auto transformer that having a supply voltage of 500 volt. So see here, the voltage V1 is equal to 400 volt, V2 is equal to 100 volt. We have to provide the supply of 500 volt. It means we should have to use the additive polarity. When we will add V1 and V2, then we will get 500 volt. So here, to make an auto transformer, we should use the additive polarity like that. If this is A point, this point is B, this point is suppose C, and this point is D. So we have to keep, this is plus minus V1 and this is plus minus V2. Then we will get here, this is V1 plus V2. V1 plus V2 is equal to how much? This is equal to 500 volt. Because V1 is 400 volt, V2 is equal to 100 volt. So we will get V1 plus V2 is equal to 500 volt. And this is dot at point C. Now, the An auto transformer to supply power at 400 volt means output voltage should be equal to 400 volt. So output voltage 400 volt is equal to V1. So we have to connect the load across terminal AB like that. We have to connect the load across terminal AB because we require the output voltage is 400 volt. So this is output voltage plus minus V1, or V1 is equal to how much? This is equal to 400 volt. If the output voltage will be equal to how much? If the output voltage will be equal to V2, V2 is equal to 100 volt. If the required voltage will be 100 volt, then we will connect the load across terminal C and D. So see here, we will use the connection diagram like that. So now we have to calculate the different current flowing through AB, flowing through CD. Now see here, in that case we don't know the direction of current AB. So here we will consider the current I3. Suppose this current is I3. So if the total entry current is I3, so total leaving current will be I3. If this current is I3, then the direction of this current through C to B will be equal to I3, because this current and this current should be same. And I3 is nothing but it is the current through CD, and current through CD is equal to I2. So this current is equal to I2. If this current is I2, so I3 will be equal to I2. Now in that case, you can see the current I3 leaving the dot. You can see the current I3 is leaving the dot. Therefore, the current here, sorry, this current is entering the dot. So here the current should leaving the dot like that. So this current is equal to I1. So here the total current is how much? It is equal to I1 plus I2. You can see clearly at point C the current I3 क्या कर रही है आपकी, enter कर रही है. C पर क्या कर रही है आपकी, current enter कर रही है. तो A पर current क्या करनी चाहिए, leave करनी चाहिए. तो total current कितनी होगी, I1 plus I2. So we can calculate the KVA output of auto transformer is equal to how much? It should be equal to, that is V1 into I1 plus I2. So V1 is how much equal to? V1 is 400 volt. 400 into I1 is 12.5, that is 12.5 plus it is 50. So after calculation, you will get KVA auto is equal to, it will be equal to 25. It will be 25 KVA. So you can see here clearly the KVA rating of two winding transformer is 5 KVA, but behind this two winding transformer is using as a auto transformer, the KVA rating of auto transformer has been increased 5 times. This is equal to 25 KVA. Okay, now I can rub it. We will calculate I1 is how much? I1 is equal to, that is 12.5 ampere, and I2 is equal to, this is 50 ampere. Okay, so we have to determine transformation ratio of auto transformer, that is K auto is equal to the total voltage, this is V1 plus V2, that is V1 plus V2 upon output voltage, how much? It is V1. So it will be equal to, that is 500 divided by 400, that is 1.25. It is the transformation ratio. Now the power transfer inductively, so that is S inductively, we have discussed that the inductively power is nothing but that is the power in this winding, that is power in this winding. So the current flowing through this winding is I1, and output and voltage across this winding is V1. So power transfer inductively will be equal to, that is V1 I1, it will be 400 into how much, I1. I1 is 12.5. So it will be 5 KVA. It will be 5 KVA. Next is power transfer conductively. So to determine the value of power transfer conductively, we have to determine the total power transfer. So ST is equal to how much? This is output voltage into output current. Output voltage is V1 and output current is I1 plus I2. and it is nothing but it is the rating of auto transformer, that is equal to 25 kVA. So the power transfer conductively will be equal to total power transfer minus power transfer inductively, that is 25 minus 5 is equal to, that is 20 kVA. The 20 kVA will be transferred conductively, means due to the conduction principle, and next 5 kVA will be transferred due to the transformer action, due to the inductive action or magnetic induction. Okay, so in this way we have determined the various parameters. Now at the last we have to determine the percentage saving in copper material required. So in the previous lecture we have determined the saving in copper material. So percentage saving in copper material, percentage saving in copper material is equal to, this is 1 upon K8 auto into 100. So it will be 1 upon 1.25 into 100, it will be equal to 80%. So the saving in copper material required is 80%. You can see here the KVA rating of two winding is 5 KVA. This 5 kVA is converted into 25 kVA. That's why if we will make this 25 kVA auto transformer to 5 kVA, then the copper saving will be 80%. So dear student, you can apply the more and more example for practice. ठीक है, बुक से आप कर सकते हो बहुत सारे एग्जाम्पल. मीन्स द कनेक्शन रिक्वायर्ड विल डिपेंड अपॉन द डेटा गिवन एंड डेटा रिक्वायर्ड, वेदर यू हैव टू यूज द स्टेप डाउन ट्रांसफॉर्मर और स्टेप अप ट्रांसफॉर्मर. सो इन दिस टू लेक्चर वी हैव फिनिश्ड द ऑटो ट्रांसफॉर्मर इन अ वेरी गुड मैनर विद सम एग्जाम्पल्स, विद सम डेरिवेशन एंड विद ऑपरेटिंग प्रिंसिपल्स. सो इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर, that is lecture number 14, we will discuss two important topics, that is the polarity test of the transformer and Sumpner back to back test. Sumpner back to back test kyun karte hain, kya requirement hoti hai, ye dono topic hum discuss karenge next lecture mein. So prepare for next lecture, or I again request to you, please subscribe the channel for most important upcoming videos and share and like the videos. Okay, thank you.